Dairy farms are a big part of California's economy, but dairy cows are also one of the state's biggest resources and sources of methane. That's a powerful greenhouse gas. Researchers at UC Davis are looking at ways to reduce emissions with a pretty simple dietary change. KCRA 3 meteorologist Heather Waldman explains in today's Forecasting Our Future story.
It may look like another lazy day for these dairy cows, but they are hard at work fighting climate change by lowering their methane emissions.
Contrary to common belief, it's not coming out of the back end, it's coming out of the front end.
An adult dairy cow produces close to 220 pounds of methane every year, just by eating and digesting their food.
The average dairy cow will eat about 100 pounds of food per day, and about half of that is food like this, almond hulls. Pretty tough to break down, but cows are ruminants, meaning they have a special microbiome that can break all of this down, but in the process, that's where the methane gets produced. Dr. Mittlerner's lab has found out that adding just a little bit of a special additive can really make a big difference.
On the dairy side, we've found approximately 10% reductions of methane.
And that's with using just 1 gram of an additive made from essential oils. Different mixtures produce different results.
We measure those differences by putting these animals into what's called a head chamber.
The cows eat and belch in these chambers. Sensors measure methane output.
And we do this over, 12 hours or so, and then we know what the modification is that's caused by this additive.
It takes a little training, but these cows are unbothered by their work environment.
They can see their peers, they can eat in there, they can drink in there, they can normally breathe and so on. It does not bother them.
And the cows don't know it, but a combination of these small dietary changes and methods of storing manure has already cut California's methane emissions by 25%.
And that's what gets me really excited, that a strong reduction of methane can be part of a climate solution, and the dairy and the beef sector can be part of that.
As long as paying for these additives is feasible for farmers.
And food additives like the one being tested here at Dr. Mittlerner's lab are already being widely used in Europe. Dr. Mittlerner says the next big step for getting commercial use here in the U.S. is FDA approval. In Davis, I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman for KCRA 3 News.